their generations as an everlasting covenant. It is a sign between me and the children of Israel forever. For in 6 days the Lord made the heavens and the earth, and on the seventh day he rested and was refreshed.
Thank you. Thank you. to the gardens. Here to worship the Lord as well. We get to all share in it together. And we get to all sing in one accord, praising the name of our God. And singing to His Son, Yeshua, who is our Redeemer.
All right. Thank you. Thank you. Yeshua, so grateful and thankful for you, Lord. Help us all from an early age to be thankful, to just bask in your presence, to realize that on a day like today, your Shabbat that you established at the beginning of time. It was a chance for us to enter into eternity for 24 hours. I remember a time even when I was in a denominational church. I'm not bragging on myself, I'm just giving an example of what is possible, what I know is happening today with some of the young people. It was a New Year's Eve night, and I knew there were some friends, some people I knew who were out partying, and I was in church. Again, I'm not bragging on myself, I just, you know, you young folks can have that kind of desire for being in the presence of the Lord, especially on Shabbat, and to concentrate on Yeshua, to have your eyes on Him, to not think or talk about anything else, especially today, but to have your eyes on Him. Even if it's too hard for 24 hours, at least during this time, in this special place that is anointed with so many prayers that have gone up, so many healings that have happened, so many changes that have made because of prayers and the praise and the worship that have gone up in this place. This is a specially anointed place for you to put your eyes on the Lord and not talk about anything else but Him or His Word, and realize that the habits you are making now, some of them, they will be with you all your lives. Thank you, Lord.
Jericho wall could have been torn down just like that, but if they hadn't done what he told them to do, the walls would not come down. And the blind man that he spot on the clay and put on his eyes and told him to go wash and receive his sight. It could have been done another way. But he did something and instructed the blind man to do something in return. And he did, and he received his sight. So, that's it. That's just it.
I'd like to share something with you. I feel that I'm in disobedience. You really know. It's been insane. A few weeks ago, during our praise session, I was looking up into the throne room to heaven. And I saw the gathering. Particularly the gathering of all the shepherds. And they were coming and looking to worship with us here. And I was so happy for our rabbi that they had chose this place of all of the places to worship us that day. And I was just in glory. And then one of the shepherds said something to another, and he pointed down and said, "That one's Albert's." That's when I almost collapsed and had to quickly remove myself from here. So they are looking and they are worshiping with us. And some of you that are young, to get into the throne room and to see and to understand, please go to Revelation 4, and maybe with your parents or friends or teacher, and read and work on that until you can see up into the heavens. This morning was such a sweet, sweet praise, and the praise forever for us to come and share our hearts. Thank you, Kennedy.
Father in heaven, Lord, thank you for this day. Thank you for this Shabbat. Lord, thank you that we are able to come here and worship freely. And Lord, right now I thank you for this time of thanksgiving. And Lord, I thank you that we were able to celebrate a holiday where we can just give thanks and give honor and praise to you, Lord. Lord, right now I come to you, and Lord, I pray for your nation Israel. And Lord, I ask that you please give them all the blessings that you could possibly give to them. Lord, give them the amount of blessings that just no one could. Just give them the amount of blessings that they deserve and they need. Lord, please give our nation the blessings that we need as well. Bless your people. Bless them in every way possible. Bless their land. Lord, bless their economy. Bless their agriculture. Every single way, Lord, I ask that you please bless them. And Lord, just please be with our nation as well, and be with us and keep us safe. And Lord, I pray this all in your name.
Amen. Avinu, our Father, our King, Lord, we proclaim your greatness now beyond the borders of Israel. We proclaim your greatness throughout the entire earth. Lord God, we bring the United States to you. Lord, we ask that your rock just flows through this country, that it reaches those that are lost, those that don't know you. Lord, we pray for every Jewish congregation in this nation, Lord, that as they go through your Torah year after year, parsha after parsha, Lord, that they see you, Lord Yeshua, all throughout it, that the Torah proclaims you, you Yeshua. Thank you for going to the tree of sacrifice. Thank you for our salvation. Thank you, Lord Yeshua, for taking care of us. Lord, we pray for all those in this country, all the other regular Sunday churches. Lord, we just ask that your blessing be with them, that your blessing and your rock just flows to those congregations, Lord. Lord God, we pray for our government. We pray that we pray for President Trump, Lord, that your rock and your peace and your joy and your wisdom just flows into him. Lord, and equally so, we pray for President-elect Joe Biden, that your Ruach, your presence, your joy, your wisdom goes into him. We pray for every person in our government as they lead us through this next 4 years, Lord, that you, Lord, are the cornerstone of this country. It is not the men of power where we find our security, Lord. It is through you, Lord Yeshua, who gives us comfort, who gives us security, who is our provider in all things. Lord, we proclaim you, God, of this country. Thank you, Lord Yeshua, for revealing to those and speaking to those in the Spirit. May everyone who knows you find divine appointments to reach somebody that does not know you. We love you and praise you, Lord God. Thank you once again for being the God of our nation. In Yeshua's name, amen.